Okay guys, what's up? It's McNeil from Louisa Automotive, and today I'm going to go through the tires and explain to you what the writings on the tires mean. Now I know a lot of you, the common stuff, you know, 235, 55, 16, those numbers, you probably know what it already mean, but I'm going to go through a lot of other markings and indicators on the tire to enlighten you as to how to read a tire and know if a tire is a good tire or not. Alright, let's take a look at this tire here for example. So if you were to go to a shop, the first thing they'd ask you, what's your tire size? And this is the most common number. This is what they want to know. 215-55-ZR17. What does that mean? The 215, the first number, would be the width from sidewall to sidewall. Okay? So you can see this here. So from here to here is 215 millimeters. The second number is height from here to here, right? But this means it is 55% of the tread. So from here to here, 55% is the height of the tire, the sidewall. The 17 would just mean the size of the rim. So from here to here is 17. Now, a little fun fact here, even for me, I always thought this R means rim size, you know, your rim size is 17, but actually it's not. The R would basically represent the ply, how the tire is constructed. The ply goes across on the inside of the tire when it's constructed. And so that is more of a common construction or application, the way they make the tire. So the tread, the ply goes this way on the inside of the tire, which you can't see. But if it had some other rating, some other different type, it would go like in an angle, right? Totally different. Z here would mean this is a performance tire. At one point in time, Z used to be the fastest speed rating on a tire. Right now, it's not, because cars go a lot faster. But then this is still a cool practice just to show you that the tire is a performance tire. So since we're talking about speed rating, we'll jump to this small number here. So you can see the same 215-55-ZR17. So this W here is the new speed rating. So Z is no longer the highest number. It will just indicate that the tire is a performance tire, like we mentioned. But this W here would be the speed rating. So you could check out how fast you could run on the tire, consistent speed. You know what I mean? So I will have to put, I would have to put a chat on our website, louisa.ca, to kind of put out, because there's way too many letters that goes here. To tell you what the speed is for those letters, right? So I'm gonna have to put a chat on our website to tell you. The 94 here would be the weight. So each tire, how much weight it can carry or recommended to carry, okay? So again, I will also put a chat online so you can see what the 94 is. But this is kind of redundant because if we look around right here, let me see if I can zoom in here. It also tells you the maximum load you can put on. So this tire here is rated for 670 kgs per tire. So the max load is 670 kgs per tire. So which means right here, this 94 would be the 670 per tire. So that times four, because you got four tires on the car, right? Since we're in this section here already, we could also look at the maximum pressure. So this one calls for 44 psi. Now understand that this is the maximum cold tire pressure. So what does cold tire pressure means is this is when you check your tire first thing in the morning, before you start driving the car, before the tire spins too much and makes the tire warm. You want to know what's your morning pressure, your cold tire pressure. So first thing in the morning, when you check your tire pressure, the maximum this tire can allow is 44 PSI. Does that mean you should put 44 PSI in this tire? No. Always check on your door of your car or your owner's manual to see how much air is recommended for your car. But the tire is telling you that this is the maximum tire pressure it can handle, okay? Or it's gonna blow. So you don't wanna put too much air in it. And the reason for these videos is that we can now compare tires, not just because the tire says made in China, right? A lot of things are made in China, but what we wanna do is we wanna compare and know that our tires are actually competitive or basically of the same class and quality of a different brand. So stop buying tires or shutting down tires just because it says made in China. Just see that the quality is still good. Now, let's go to this section here where you see DOT. So basically, this would just means that this tire is streetworthy, legal in North America. So if it has DOT, it's legal to use in Canada, United States, and a lot of other countries. It's basically streetworthy. So your government it meets the requirements to drive on the roads in North America. Okay. This section here is the date of birth of the tire. So this tire was the first week of 2019. It was made. First week of 2019. Okay. Then we're gonna move to the tread wear. The tread wear is The tread wear is 360. The tread wear is 360. The higher this number is, the longer it takes for the tire to wear out. But keep in mind, performance tires normally wear out quicker. So whenever you're buying a Z tire, basically this tend to be lower. Okay, so it could be a little bit less, maybe even 620. But in this case, this one is 360. But on a regular car, the higher this number, the better for you. Okay. Then when you go on to traction, sometimes you would see A, but it's actually a rating higher than A. There's a rating for double A. This would just means on wet roads, stopping in a straight line, the tire stops very well or performs very well if it has a double A. So A is also a very good rating, but double A is the highest rating that you can get. This here that says outside, normally some tires would have the word rotational on it or have an arrow indicating which angle the tire should spin or rotate at. This one, just for the guy installing the tire, will know that this side of the tire should be on the outside of the car and the other side will say inside. The temperature rating also, which means when the car is performing at high speeds and it heats up, it basically performs very well in hot temperatures as well. So A is also a good indicator here for your temperature. There's a lot of other small indicators on the tire that's basically just mostly manufacturer coding in case there's a recall on the tire, and they would know when it was made to know when to recall it. So that's not really necessary right now. I don't want to bore you with like all of the dots on the tire, but at least these are the main things you need to know if you're trying to compare a premium tire versus an economy tire. You want to know how quickly it wears out. You want to know what the temperature, what the pressure it can handle, the load it can handle, and if basically it's a good fit for your car and can compete based on price. So don't just buy the tire based on the brand name, because keep in mind, even the big brand names out there like Michelin, they would have different levels and different standards. So there'd be like it could be a Michelin Performance and a Michelin Economy, and you may not even know. You may just be paying too much money because the name says Michelin, but the ratings on it can be really crappy and really shitty. So no matter the brand you choose to buy, look at the ratings, look at the performance on the tires. It will help you make a more informed decision. Hopefully this was helpful, guys. Peace.